Everything is data. The phone is data. The TV is data. The internet is data. Our jobs are data. Our government services are data. Our friends and family, our homework, our entertainment, our shopping, our social lives. Everything is data. In a very short period of time, computer technology has evolved from corporate and hobby appliances to an essential part of our daily lives. Tasks that once took days to complete can now be accomplished almost immediately. Unfortunately, the technology that delivers our data hasn't fully caught up with our ever-increasing appetite for data, which is why we're here today. We must develop a plan that will fix our chronic data problems across the entire nation. But first, where exactly is the source of our problems? We'll start by examining the data networks that run between the country's major data centers, also known as the Internet backbone. This infrastructure can carry huge amounts of data, is upgraded constantly, and the owners appear to be on good speaking terms with each other. Everything seems fine here. Next are the service providers. They appear to be doing a good job of providing the services we need, especially the smaller companies that deliver better services to their customers, as opposed to the larger companies that deliver better returns to their shareholders. That leaves us with the last mile, or the line that runs all the way to your home. This line can consist of a variety of wired and wireless technologies with very distinct performance characteristics. So how well is that working for? Doesn't look like the last mile is working very well, does it? The last mile has been the source of our misery, the bottleneck that's been holding us back. If Canada's internet backbone were comparable to a huge aqueduct, the data connection in our homes would be comparable to a leaky faucet, and that's if you have access to plumbing. So how do we fix our pipes? The most practical solution would be to replace the last mile with glass. A single strand can easily satisfy an entire household's appetite for data, even when operating at its slow speed. And we've yet to discover just how fast it can go. However, replacing the entire last mile network with glass would be a massive and expensive undertaking, which is why the current owners of the last mile haven't been in a rush to replace it all, especially if they have to share it with their competitors. They don't like to share. To further complicate things, the owners of the last mile prefer to install their glass in densely populated areas in order to maximize their revenues, leaving many lesser populated areas with slow or no data services, even in newly built suburbs. Our current problems with the owners of the last mile are very similar to the problems we've once had with the owners of private electric utilities, just before many of them were driven out or bought out by the government. No, we're not expropriating obsolete private networks. That would be a mistake. Instead, let's explore our options for building a modern public network, starting from the top. What if the federal government built and operated a national broadband network? Australia already tried that, and it cost them a lot more than they had expected. Okay, how about the provincial and territorial governments? Many of them already operate highly profitable public utilities, offering excellent services at reasonable prices. Then I remembered I live in Ontario. Okay, how about local governments? They already manage water and sewer networks, and they would know which parts of their community require improved data services. In fact, many North American communities have already built highly successful and fully serviced municipal broadband networks. However, wiring up an entire area with glass and providing the services could be a bit much for some communities, so let's scale it down a bit. The community receives government funding to build the network, then leases it to existing service providers. Let's call this option the Community Network Initiative. Has a nice ring to it, doesn't it? While it's true we must confirm the economic viability of this plan, the Community Network Initiative could greatly improve a community's data services, as well as create new public revenue streams, new business opportunities, and new high-level jobs. So the community gets the government funding, builds the network, and leases it to the service providers.
What are the operating rules?
1. No services or exclusive access. Communities receiving public funding for their network will be barred from providing their own services and must lease access to their network to all qualified service providers on a non-exclusive basis.
2. No selling out.
Publicly funded community networks can't be sold to private interests for a minimum of 10 years after becoming operational. Furthermore, any private interest that buys a community network after the 10-year period must not be a service provider or have any connections with a service provider.
3. No more sharing.
Once a publicly funded community network becomes operational, the owners of existing last-mile networks located in the same area will no longer be required to share access to their networks with other service providers. Consequently, the community won't be required to share access to their networks with non-sharing last-mile owners. As more community networks are built, and as more communities are connected with each other, a redundant network will form, greatly increasing the resilience of a region's network infrastructure. Most subscribers won't even notice that a line has been cut, as their data will automatically be redirected through alternate community networks. Now we're left with households located too far away from a community network, as well as communities located too far away from an internet backbone or a connected community. We can't use the old technology, and running glass over long distances for a few households could get very expensive. We need a more cost-effective solution to get the job done. We must launch a research and development program with the goal of inventing long-distance networking solutions that can be deployed almost anywhere in the country at minimal cost. Since this network will be deployed outside of most local jurisdictions, the provincial and territorial governments will be responsible for its maintenance and operation. And that's the Community Network Initiative, a project that empowers communities to improve their access to data, connecting these communities to all of Canada and to the world. Other countries will also benefit from the technological innovations created by this initiative, bringing communities worldwide closer together and improving people's lives by improving their access to essential data. Because today, everything is data, and data is our lives. Thank you for watching.